So the first activity we're going to look at is what we're calling a splash activity. This is responsible for this particular beautiful splash screen you are seeing right now. Okay, we had already designed it, so we just want to animate these particular widgets and then of course give way to our dashboard page. So this is it. Take note of the logo, it's being dropped slightly, and then take note of the two text views, they are being faded in. Okay, these are the two main things we're going to do right now. Of course, it's an activity, so it's going to extend the app compat activity. We start by defining our instance fields, which in this case are just our widgets. We then initialize these widgets, basically referencing them from our layout. Then, of course, the first thing is for us to load our animation. So we load our top to bottom animation. Then we apply that animation on our logo. Then we load our fade in animation. Apply it to our title as well as the subtitle. Then we'll come over and go over to our dashboard, okay, using this method. So all we need to do right now is to come instantiate our thread, then of course override the run method. Then we try, of course we sleep for 2000 milliseconds, 2 seconds. Then of course we open our dashboard activity, then we finish the current splash screen. We're going to catch an interrupted exception. To actually start the thread, we need to invoke the start method. Then of course we come right here, we've already our touch base context. We're doing this one, of course, so that we can apply the custom fonts onto this particular page as well. Okay, that is courtesy of our calligraphy library. Then we're going to come and then override our onCreate method. We're going to initialize our widgets, show our splash animation, then go to dashboard. That's it. This is what will make up our splash activity.java. Let's move over to our next activity.